myself Deepthna, assistant professor EC department. So today I'm going to tell a topic based on what is rectifier. So rectifier is nothing but these rectifiers where we are using what is this and where we are using this. So coming to before discussing about the what, where. So where we are using this rectifiers. We are using this rectifiers in our power supplies. So power supply devices, any of the power supply devices, we are using this rectifier. So what is the use of rectifier now? What? What is the use of this rectifiers? Rectifiers are nothing but, coming to the definition of the rectifiers, rectifiers is nothing but it is an electrical device which converts, that means this is a device which is converting the AC. AC is nothing but whatever switch we are using, our switches for fan, for charging purpose, for current purpose, we are using a number of switches. So from the switch, on off switch, we are getting AC of 230 volts. We are getting a current of 230 volts. If we directly give this to our charger or else any electronic appliances, what will happen? That this is like a huge amount of current from coming from our switches. So if we give directly this to our electronic appliances, the electronic appliances will fail to work, because these electronic appliances only work on certain voltage. These electronic devices can work only certain current. So these rectifiers, what is the use of these rectifiers? If we keep a rectifier in any of the electronic device, this is converting the whatever AC we are getting, this is converting AC into whatever we want into DC. So actual definition of rectifiers comes like, which converts AC, which is coming from our switches, AC into DC of whatever voltage we require. So this rectifiers we are using in any of the power supply devices or else any of the electronic appliances.
Okay.
So the actual definition of rectifiers like will be like, converts AC into pulsating DC, which allows current in only one direction. Here one direction is nothing but only in certain direction. That means a forward direction or else reverse direction. So the actual definition of rectifier stands like, converts AC, which is coming from there, into pulsating DC in only one direction. So this is actual meaning of the rectifiers. But we are dividing these rectifiers as n number of rectifiers. Based on the applications, we are dividing these rectifiers. Like just we discussed what are the types of rectifiers we are having and what is the use of that rectifiers and what are the applications of that rectifiers. Coming to the first rectifier is half wave rectifier. The next is full wave rectifier. The next is bridge rectifiers. Just we will be discussing what is the purpose of these three rectifiers and what is the use of that rectifiers, how we do it, rectify the current. So first we go for half wave. So before going to this rectifier, in the rectifier we are using, just we have discussed in the definition of the rectifier, like it allows current in only one direction. That means for the current to flow in one direction, we are using one device which is called as diode. So this is a diode which allows the current to flow only in the one direction, that is in the forward direction or else in the reverse direction. So coming to this rectifier, we are using diode as an component in the rectifiers. Just half wave rectifier. So if we give any input, so we are giving input as sine wave. If we are giving in, input are sideway, what is the output? Based on this rectifier, we will be knowing in this half wave rectifier. This we will go for the circuit diagram of this rectifier. One diode we are using, this is a resistor, it is variable resistor, and this is the output section where we are checking the output. This is the input section from where we are giving AC 230 volts, like this we are giving at the transformer. What is the use of transformer? Transformer also does, like, it is converting 230 into whatever the voltage we require, it is converting. So the whatever voltage we are giving at the transformer is given to the diode, and the using this variable resistance. What is the use of this resistor? It resists the flow of current. That means whatever we require the current, it only resists that certain amount of current into the circuit. So from here we are giving input. This is analyzing, and the flow of the current is decided by this diode. Using this variable resistance, we are checking the output. So we check the output. Firstly, I am giving sine wave as the input and the output section. Just we will check once how the condition of this diode works and how this will be having. So this is the input I am giving, V input. Here I am giving sine wave. This is a positive edge, this is the negative edge of the sine wave. If the positive edge is coming, the diode whatever this is in the forward bias condition. That means forward bias condition. So this diode will be in on stage, and the positive edge will be getting in the output section. That means diode will be in the on stage and will be getting only the positive edge of the output. Yes, and again if this is negative signal is applied at the input, the diode will be in off stage and the negative half cycle will be becoming zero, because diode will be in the off stage. That means no current flows through the circuit and no waveform will be in the output section. And again the same process continues. Again if the positive edge is like this, the diode again will become in on stage. Again, the positive waveform will be coming in the output section. So this is the output of this circuit explanation. So half wave rectifier. The name itself implies that only half wave is generated in this format. So what is the use of this half wave rectifier? This is used in certain devices where we are requiring only half of the current. That means only a certain limit of current is limited by this half wave rectifier. So by coming to the full wave as well as bridge rectifier, full wave is like a full wavelength. A full wavelength is coming at the output section and a full current is gaining at the output section. So this is the difference between half wave and full wave. So these are the waveforms for the half wave. Just we discuss how the full wave looks like. Coming to the half wave, we are using only one diode. Coming to full wave rectifier, just we check the circuit diagram of this. When we are comparing half wave and full wave, in the half wave rectifier we are using only one diode. Based on the condition of on, off, we are getting the output waveforms. While coming to the full wave, we are having two diodes. this is diode D1 and this is diode D2. And diode D1 will be in the forward bias condition, that means positive, positive. The diode D2 is in the reverse bias condition. That means just I am reversing the position of the diode. Just we'll check how the waveforms will be. So first, at the input section, I am giving the sine wave. For the positive half cycle, what happens to the positive half cycle? If the positive half cycle is applied at the input, positive half cycle, the diode D1 will be in the on stage. Diode D1 will be in the on state, that is forward bias condition, and on stage the output, this is input, the output, exact output will be getting at the output section. When a negative half cycle is given to the circuit, a negative half cycle is given, diode D1 will be reverse biased, that means off stage, and D2 will be in forward bias, that is on stage. Then what happens here? We are using two diodes, that is the difference between half wave and full wave. So diode, any one of the diode is in on stage, that means the negative edge also will be coming the output at the output section. So while going to this half wave rectifier, what is happening? Only one diode we are using. If that diode becomes off, no output at the output section, that means current flow is zero. When coming to the full wave rectifier, we are using another diode, which implies the negative half cycle also will be getting one output at the output section. If this continues, again if positive half cycle is given as an input, same diode D1 will be in the on stage, that is forward bias condition, and diode D2 will be in the off stage. If I give negative half cycle to the input section, what happens? Diode D1 will be in the reverse bias condition, that means it will be in off stage, and D2 will be in the forward bias and on stage. So we will be getting like this pulses, that means only positive full cycles will be getting in the output section. This is the difference between this half wave and full wave rectifier. So where we are using this full wave rectifier? We are using this full wave rectifier for the full functioning of the current. That means if you want to get a huge large amount of current, so we are using this full wave rectifier in such power supply circuits. So this is nothing but half wave and full wave rectifier. So just we have discussed in the rectifier definition that it is converting only AC into pulsating DC. So what I mean by this pulsating DC? Pulsating DC is nothing but whatever output we are getting, that is DC, that contains some pulses. So contains some pulses. So to remove that pulses, what we are using? We are using filter to remove pulses which are in the DC. So filter, what is the meaning of this filter? If we take randomly, so filter. So what is the use of this filter? As we have discussed in the definition of the rectifier, it converts AC into pulsating DC. So what is meant by this pulsating? Whatever the DC we are getting, it contains some pulses. So to remove that pulses, what we are using? We are using filter as a component in the output section of any of the rectifiers. So what components we are using as filter? So we are using capacitor and inductor as a filter component. So this is the meaning of this filter. While coming to the bridge rectifier. So we have discussed half wave as well as full wave rectifier, where we are using only one diode. Here we are using only two diodes. While coming to this bridge rectifier, we are using four diodes. Four diodes, D1, D2, D3 and D4. So what is the use of this bridge rectifier? It is used in the many of the applications. While we compare with the half wave as well as full wave, we are using bridge rectifiers in many of the applications. Why? Because efficiency. Because of efficiency. What do you mean by this efficiency? Efficiency is nothing but what is the capacity of that rectifier. So what is the power it is giving? What is the voltage the full voltage it is giving, what is the power it is giving. So this is nothing but efficiency. So in many of the applications we are using bridge rectifier as a rectifier because of this efficiency. It gives the maximum efficiency. So this is nothing but the rectifier's topic. Thank you.